Hi friends, today I am giving a lecture on B-tree insertion with order 3. That means how to perform the insertion operation on a B-tree with order 3. Okay, so here order 3 is nothing but order can be represented by capital M. So M is equal to 3. That means B-tree of order 3 can be represented by M is equal to 3. Whenever order of a B-tree M is equal to 3, it satisfies two conditions. First one is how many number of key elements for a node in a B-tree of order 3 is nothing but M minus 1 number of keys. That is 3 minus 1, that is 2 keys or exist in a node in a B-tree of order 3. How many number of childrens for a node is at most M children, that is at most it contain 3 children. Okay, so that means every node in the B tree of order 3 contains 2 key elements and 3 children. So these conditions should be satisfied while constructing the B tree of order 3. Now, this is the notation I have to follow. So this is a node, that node contains a key element. Now this line represents the left pointer points to a left subtree that contains the key elements less than k. Next, this line represents the right pointer. The right pointer points to a right subtree that contains the key elements greater than k. Okay, so here the elements in the right subtree that are greater than k. Here the elements in the left subtree less than k. So this condition should be keep in mind while constructing the B tree of order 3. Okay, now this is the example problem. Now we have to construct B tree of order 3 by using these elements. So initially B tree is empty. So in the B tree, the insertion can be always done at the leaf node. Okay. Next, first insert 10. So initially B tree is empty. Whatever the first element that is inserted into the B tree, that is the first node, that is the root node, and that is the leaf node. Okay, so we have to create a node. So in that node we have to write the key element 10. So this is the first node in the B tree. This is the leaf node and this is also a root node. Okay. Next, we have to insert 34. So before inserting 34, the existing B tree is this one. So it contains a single node that contains the key element 10. So 34 is compared with 10. 34 is greater. So now 34 can be inserted to the right of 10. Okay. So in the B tree of order 3, so every node may contain at most two key elements and 3 children. Okay, here so 10 is one key element and 34 is another key element. Okay, so this node contains 2 key elements. Every node can contain how many number of key elements are 2 key elements. 10 is one key element and 34 is another key element. So this is a B tree of order 3 because it contains a node that contains 2 key elements, 10 and 34. Okay, here this node does not contain any children. Okay, next we have to insert 78. Before insert 78, the existing B tree contains a node that contains 2 key elements, 10. So now 78 is inserted into that B tree. First, find out the location of 78 where we have to insert. 78 is compared with 10. So 78 is greater. 78 is compared with 34. 78 is greater. So 78 can be inserted to the right of 34. Okay. So after inserting at this position 78, how many number of key elements in that node? There are 3 key elements in that node. But how many number of keys are present in a node of order B of order 3 of B tree, only 2 key elements. But here, how many number of key elements are there? So 3 key elements are there. So at that time, so we have to perform splitting operation. So the splitting operation can be performed. So here there are 3 key elements are there. So 3 by 2. So 3 by 2 is nothing but so 1.5. So 1.5 ceiling value is equal to 2. Okay. At second index, we have to perform the splitting operation. The middle element, that is 2, can be taken as the parent node. Okay. So now, this invalid node is converted into valid node by taking the middle element as parent node. And this is the left child and this is the right child. So now, 34 is the parent node and its left child is 10 and its right child is 78. Okay, because in the B tree of order 3, every node must contain 2 key elements. After inserting 78, this node contains 3 key elements. This is an invalid node in the B tree of order 3. So that to convert this invalid node into valid node, we have to perform the splitting operation. The splitting operation can be performed by taking the middle element. Middle element is, so 3 by 2 ceiling value is 1.5. 1.5 ceiling value is 2. At index 2, 34 is there. So the middle element 34 can be taken as parent. And before 34, whatever the elements are there, that are the left child of 34. After 34, what is the element is there? That is the right child of 34. So now this is the B tree we are getting after inserting 78. Next, insert 45. So before insert 45, the existing B tree is 34 is the root node and its left child is 10 and right child is 78. Okay. Now, first 45 is compared with the element in the root node. 45 is compared with the 34. 45 is greater. So go to the right pointer of 34. So it contains a subtree. It contains a node. That node contains the key element 78. So now 45 is compared with the 78. 45 is lesser. So that, so 45 can be inserted before the 78. So now, because 45 is less than 78. Okay. So after inserting 45, so this is the B tree we are getting. Okay. So next we have to insert 123. Insert 123. So before inserting 123, the existing B tree is 34 is the root node and 10 is the left child and the right child is 45 and 78. Okay. First, we have to find out the location of 123 where we have to insert. So first, 123 is compared with the key element in the root node, that is 34. 123 is compared with 34, it is greater. Go to the right pointer that points to a right subtree that contains a node. It contains two key elements. So 123 is compared with the first key element, that is 45. It is greater. Next, 123 is compared with the 78. So 123 is greater. Here, 123 can be inserted after 78. Okay. But, so suppose 128 is inserted. Okay. So, this node contains how many number of key elements? 3 key elements. But according to the property, every node can contain at most 2 key elements. So that, so after inserting 128, this is an invalid node. Okay. To convert this invalid node into valid node, we are taking the middle element as the parent node. How many number of elements are there? 3 key elements are there. The middle element can be taken as 3 by 2 ceiling value. So that is 1.5, that is ceiling value is 2. 1.5 ceiling value is 2. So at index 2, what is the element is there? That is 78. Now 78 can be taken as parent. 78 left child is 45, 78 right child is 128, and 78 can be added to the parent 34. Okay, so to convert this invalid node into valid node, we have to perform the splitting operation. After performing splitting operation, the middle element can be taken as the parent. That middle element can be added to the root node. Okay, so after that we are getting is, so 34, the middle element is 78. 78 can be added to the parent. Okay, so 34 left child is 10 and 34 right child is 45 or 75 left child. And 128. So after inserting 128, so this is the B tree we are getting. So 78 right child is 128. 128 is greater than 78. So 34, 78, in between them 45 is there. So 45 is greater than 34. 45 is less than 78. Here 34 left child is 10, 10 less than 34. Okay, so next, after inserting 123, next we have to insert 341. Insert 341. So before inserting 341, so the existing B tree is, so 34, 78 is the root node, its left child is 10 and the middle child is 45 and the right child is 128. Okay, first we have to find out the location of 341 where we have to insert. So 341 is compared with the key elements in the root node. 341 is compared with 34, 341 is greater. 341 is compared with 78, 341 is greater. Go to the right subtree of 78, it contains a node, that node contains a key element 128. So now 341 is compared with 128, it is greater. So 341 can be inserted to the right of 128. So now this node contains two key elements, that is 128 and 341. Okay, so after inserting 341, this is the B tree we are getting. It satisfies all the properties. Okay, next we have to insert 234. So insert 234. Okay, so before inserting 234, The existing B tree is, so 34 and 78, its left child is 10, 34 right child or 78 left child is 45 and 78 right child is 128 and 341. Okay. First, we have to find out the location where we have to insert 234. 234 is compared with the key elements in the root node. The root node contains two key elements, 34 and 78. 234 is compared with the 34. 234 is greater. 234 is compared with the 78. 234 is greater. Go to the right subtree of 78. So this is the right pointer, points to a right subtree. It contains a single node that contains two key elements, 128 and 341. 234 is compared with 128. So 234 is greater. And 234 is compared with the second key element, 341. 234 is less than 341. Here, 234 is inserted in between 128 and 341. So suppose 234 is inserted at this point, this node contains three key elements. Okay, so three key elements are there in that node, so it is not a valid node. Okay, so to convert this invalid node into valid node, we have to perform the splitting operation at this node. The splitting operation can be performed by taking the middle element as parent. Here, this is the first element, this is the second element, this is the third element. Here, the middle element is 234. So, this 234 can be taken as the parent. So, its left child is 128 and its right child is 341. So, this 234 can be added to the root node. Here, the root node contains, after adding 234, again it contains three key elements, 34, 78 and 234. Okay. So, it is not an invalid node. Okay. Again, we have to perform the splitting operation on this node. The middle, here 234 is there. The middle element is 78. Now, 78 can be taken as parent. Its left child is 34 and its right child is 234. Okay. Here perform splitting operation. Here perform splitting operation. Okay. Two splitting operation is performed. After performing two splitting operation, we are getting the node 78 is the root node. Okay. Its left child is 34 and its right child is 234. Okay. Next, 34 left child is 10 and 34 right child is 45. And 234 left child is 128. And 234 right child is 341. So this is the B tree we are getting after inserting 234. Suppose here we are performing the splitting operation. So now 230 middle element is 234. 234 as the parent. 234 left child is 128, 234 right child is 341. Okay, so this 234 can be added to this node. Again, this node contains three key elements. It is an invalid node because every node must contain at most two key elements. But here there are three key elements are there after inserting 234. Now the middle element is 78. Now 78 can be taken as parent and its left child is 34 and its right child is 234. Okay. So now 34 left child is 10, 34 right child is 45, 234 left child is 128, 234 right child is 341. Before 234, 128 is there. After 234, 341 is there. So this is the B tree we are getting after inserting 234. Next, we have to insert 167. So now, next insert 167. First, 167 is compared with 78, that is the root node. So 167 is compared with the key element in the root node. So 78, so 167 is greater. Go to the right pointer that points to the right subtree that contains a node 234. So 167 is compared with 234. 167 is a lesser. Go to the left pointer that points to a left subtree. So that left subtree contains a node 123. 167 is compared with 123. So 167 is greater than 123. So now 167 can be inserted to the right of 123. So now, so 167. So after inserting 167, so this is the B tree we are getting. Okay. So next we have to insert 159. Okay. So before inserting 159, the existing tree is, so this is 78, So the left subtree is 34, its left child is 10, and its right child is 45. Okay, next, 78 right child is 234, and its left child contains, so 123 and 167, and 234 right child is 341. Okay, so now 159 is compared with the key element in the root node. So 159 is compared with 78. 159 is greater. Go to the right pointer that points to a right subtree that contains the node 234. 159 is compared with the 234. It is a lesser. Go to the left pointer that points to a left subtree that contains a node. That node contains two key elements, 123 and 167. So 159 is compared with the first key element, that is 123. 159 is greater. 159 is compared with the second key element, 167. So it is lesser. So in between 123 and 167, so 159 can be inserted. Okay. So now this node becomes, so 123, so 159 and 167. But it is not a invalid node, because in the B tree of order 3, every node must contain at most two key elements. But here three key elements are there. Again, we have to perform the splitting operation. So the splitting operation can be performed by taking the middle element, can be taken as parent. The middle element is, so here 1, 2, 3, the middle element is 3 by 2. So here 1.5 ceiling value is equal to 2. The middle element is 159. So now 159 taken as parent, and its left child is 123 and its right child is 167. Now 159 can be added to the parent. Parent is 234. So after adding, we are getting, so 78 is the root node, and its right child is, it contains two key elements. 159 can be added to the its parent. The parent contains 234. 159 is compared with 234. It is lesser. So first we have to write 159, and the next we have to write 234. Okay. Now 234 right child contains a key element. So that is 341. Okay, 159 left child is, before 159, 123 is there. So that is the left child of 159. 159 right child is 167. After 159, what is there? 167 is there. So that is 167. And there is no changes in the left subtree of 78. So that is 34. And its left child is 10, and its right child is 45. So this is the B tree we are getting after inserting 159. Okay, so next we have to insert next we have to insert 52. Insert 52. Okay. So now, before inserting 52, the existing B tree is, here this is 78. So 78 left is 34, and 34 left is 10, 34 right is 45. Okay. So now 78 right child is 159 and 234. So now 159 left is 123. So 159 middle and 234 left child is 167, and 234 right child is 341. First, we have to find out the location of where we are inserting 52. So 52 is compared with the root node. The root node contains key element 78. 52 is compared with 78. 52 is less than 78. Okay, go to the left pointer that points to a left subtree. The left subtree contains a node 34. So 52 is compared with 34. It is greater. Go to the right pointer, points to a right subtree. The right subtree contains a node 45. Now 52 is compared with the key element 45. So 52 is greater than 45. So 52 can be inserted to the right of 45. So now this node contains two key elements 45 and 52. Okay. So next we have to insert 83. Okay. Insert 83. Okay. So before inserting 83, so 78 is the root node and its left child is 34. 34 left child is 10 and 34 right child contains a node that contains two key elements 45 and 52, and 78 right child contains a node that contains two key elements 159 and 234, and 159 left child is 123 and middle child is 167 and right child is 341. Okay. 341. Okay. Now 83 is, before inserting, find out the location of 83. So 83 is compared with 78. 83 is greater than 78. Go to the right pointer. That right pointer points to a right subtree that contains a node. That node contains two key elements, 159 and 234. So 83 is compared with 159. 83 is less than 159. Go to the left pointer of 159 that points to a left subtree that contains a node 123. So now 83 is compared with 129. 83 is less than 123. Now 83 can be inserted before 123. So because 83 is less than 123. Okay. So after inserting 83, this is the B tree of order 3 we are getting. So now check, it is a B tree or not. It satisfies these properties or not. Every node must contain at most two key elements. This node at most two means it may contain one element or it may contain two elements. So this node contains two elements, this node contains two key elements, this node contains two key elements. The remaining all are contains a single element. First property is satisfied. Second property, so every node may contain at most three children. At most three children means it may contain two children or three children or one children. So this node contain two children, this node contain three children, this node contain two children. Okay, it satisfies the second property also. So this is the final B tree after inserting all the elements into the B tree of order 3. Okay, so thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please share this video to your friends and classmates. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel name. So Divvela Srinivasa Rao. So if you have any doubts in that one, please contact me. My WhatsApp number is also there in the channel. Okay, so thank you.